This is FYI on Your TV, brought to you by Hometown News. I'm Kathy Botham. I have got Carolee Mason with me. You are a director at the Studio Theatre Perth, a musical that's coming up. We're looking forward to this one.
This is Scrooge the Musical by Leslie Brickus, an English composer, and it is, I think, going to be a real crowd pleaser and toe tapper.
Absolutely. It's the time of year. We all like to watch the movie Scrooge, but we're going to see it live here in our Studio Theatre Perth, too. And it's a musical.
It is. It is that same old story, but with a Scrooge who sings, and a community that has a chorus around him, and of course the lovely singing Cratchit family. And it's the same story, but with some amazing music, a live band, a nine-piece band under the direction of Brad Mills, just off stage, with a horn section and keyboards and percussion. It's crowded up there. For that reason, we have taken a slightly different approach to staging, where we're using the whole space. We're not just on stage. We spill off into the aisles and into the theater. And in fact, with our large cast of about 33 people, plus our nine musicians and a crew of about 12 running every show, our actors are going to arrive at the theater in costume, and they're going to mingle with the audience prior to the opening of the show. So it's going to feel a little bit like a historical reenactment of Christmas Eve, 1843.
All right. Now, you know, when you go into the theater, that you have so many plays going on there at the Studio Theatre Perth. This has got a different element to it because you're asking people to sing. So was it harder to get the actors, or did they already come with the talents? How did you do that?
It appeals to a different part of the performing community. A lot of our performers are active in church choirs, or are trained in musical theater. We have a number of cast members who have studied musical theater and are always looking for a chance to perform on stage in a musical. So it's a different clientele, quite a different segment of the Perth and the wider community of people who particularly like musical theater.
And you must have a big cast this time too, because, I mean, we've got the young Ebenezer, the middle-aged youth Ebenezer, the older one. You must have a lot of people backstage.
Well, we have a cast of over 30.
Wow.
And many costume changes, and the band occupies all of stage left. So we have so many bodies, we can't accommodate them backstage or even in the wings. So that's why the approach we're taking is a kind of Dickens meets Brecht, I'm calling it, where we're using the whole space, and the theatricality is a little more transparent. So you actually see people coming down the aisles and moving props and things onto the stage from the aisle. So we've transformed our audience into a Victorian London square on Christmas Eve.
Oh, that's exciting. That's exciting. Now, and somebody that may not know what the storyline of Scrooge is, can you talk about that? Tell them what it's like?
Well, it's a very basic story of redemption. Ebenezer Scrooge, the much despised miser in the community, is visited by several ghosts on Christmas Eve, starting with the ghost of his old partner in his money lending business, Jacob Marley, who warns him that he will be visited by three ghosts. One ghost is going to look at his past and all the mistakes he made. One ghost is going to show him the present and give him some new perspective on what's really going on around him. And then the ghost of Christmas yet to come shows him what his life could be if he continues on his current path. So there's a little bit of It's a Wonderful Life in it as well, the idea of seeing what could be and what might be. And Scrooge realizes through his journey what he must do if he's to be happy.
Excellent.
And that's why it has a happy ending. And he really learns about goodness and kindness when he meets the Cratchit family. The Cratchits are the family of his employee, Bob Cratchit, whom he mistreats terribly, but he realizes when he sees the Cratchits in their home with Tiny Tim, their little boy who's ill, that there are kind things that Scrooge himself can do to help the Cratchits. And by learning to be kind and help others, he learns to be happy in himself.
Now, you as the director, I mean, you've taken on the element of it being a musical as well, too. So we talked before we went on air, you have a background in drama and teaching English as well, too. Musically wise, too? How about that?
Well, I'm not the musical director. Brad Mills is the musical director, but I love musicals, and I studied music as part of my my own training and in theater. And I actually started out, my very first theater gig as a theater student was with the Canadian Opera Company. So I love large-scale musical production. So that was sort of how my particular inclination to work in this medium began.
Well, and you brought all your skill and your talent, and you taught the children of the Perth area at PDCI too. So that was great that you did that too. How long did you do that for?
I was at PDCI for 31 years. And in those 31 years, we did 28 of those years, we did at least two and often three productions every year. And some of them were musicals. We did a musical every holiday season. And we used to bus all of the local school children from Lanark and into Leeds, Grenville, to come to PDCI, to our big auditorium there. And they were able to see live theater. So it's interesting for me that several of my former students are in this production. I knew them when they were in grade 9, and now they're adults and they're working with me again. Three of the women in this show did this same show with me many, many, many years ago at Perth Collegiate.
They did Scrooge with you?
They did Scrooge,
it
yes.
Oh, wow.
Liked it so much we wanted to do it again. I mean, it's a timeless classic. So I have someone who did the show with me in 1983, another one who did it with me in 1988, another one who did it with me in 2001, who is also my daughter. So she had her first appearance as a three-year-old in a walk-on in the 1980s, and now she's Mrs. Cratchit.
Oh, wow. That is awesome. That's a great story. That's a great story. Thank you for sharing that, for sure. For sure. Now, how do you get tickets to go to this play?
Well, tickets are available online through Tickets Please, and also from the Studio Theatre box office. But the Tickets Please tickets are available for $27, $5 off for opening night, which is this coming Thursday. And the best deal of all is that students and students with ID and children can buy a ticket for $10 at the door.
Wow.
So it's a good deal for families who want to bring the kids.
Absolutely. So opening night is November 24th, and then you're running this weekend.
That's right.
And then the following weekend, December 1st, 2nd, 3rd, and 4th.
Yes, and the extra bonus is on the Saturdays. Each week we are doing a matinee and an evening performance. And with this coming weekend being Perth's old-fashioned Christmas, we are adding to the local Victorian color by performing both in the afternoon and the evening this Saturday, and then again next Saturday during the Santa Claus Parade weekend.
That's right. We got the Santa Claus Parade coming in Perth as well, too. So you're running November 24th, 25th, 26th, 27th, then the following weekend, December 1st, 2nd, 3rd, and 4th.
And with doubles on the Saturdays.
And you've got mm-hmm. matinees, too. And you'll be out and about during the Santa Claus Parade.
Well, we're certainly a warm stopping off point if people want to come into town early, watch the show, and then watch the Santa Claus Parade.
Excellent, excellent. What's the address of the theater?
We are at the corner of Gore Street and the little side street that goes to the Crystal Palace.
That's right.
The name of which, I drive it every day, but I haven't got it off the top of my head, but everybody knows that corner.
That's right.
And it's we're just at the corner of the Crystal Palace, and you'll see our sandwich board out on the street.
Excellent, excellent. Well, thank you very much for joining us today and bringing some more traditions and timeless classics to our area too, right there in Perth. I've got Carolee Mason. You are the director of Scrooge the Musical at our Studio Theatre in Perth. Thanks for joining us, and Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, and thank you for having us on today, Kathy.